Hello and welcome one and all. As I've said in two of my other videos, I basically need to watch something which matches what I'm playing. It's only natural, I'm sure you've played a game and wished it had a TV show or movie, or been watching a TV show and wished it had a game. Problem is, I always have difficulty actually finding TV shows that go with my games. Google either brings up things that just aren't what I'm looking for, or the most obvious things that are the first thing you think of. Like fantasy? You'll like Game of Thrones. Well, no shit. Of course I'd like Game of Thrones. But recently I've had some success finding stuff. So I thought I'd share that success, slight as it is, with you. And I decided to put my best foot forward with what to watch if you like The Witcher. I have one main recommendation and a few other side recommendations that I'll speak more about in future videos. So, what is my main recommendation, you ask? Well, you might be able to guess if you've seen my other video, but I wholeheartedly 100% recommend Claymore. It's a Japanese anime. If you don't like anime, stay with me. You might like this one. About warriors mutated to better hunt monsters called Yoma. Sound familiar? You can see why it might go well with Witcher. The monster hunters, the Claymores, even have golden eyes. There are, of course, differences. Claymores aren't exactly mutated so much as hybridized with the monsters they hunt, leading to an eternal struggle to stay in control until eventually, inevitably, turning into Yoma themselves. They have to be careful and conservative with how much of their abilities they use, lest they hasten their inevitable transformation. The more Yoma power they use, the more grotesque they become, temporarily. The transformation into full Yoma is a sudden one that's built up to. It's when they use 10% of their Yoma power that their eyes turn gold as well. They're not always gold, they're normally silver. But still. The primary reason Claymores are mutated is so that they can detect the Yoma, as Yoma are a lot like body snatchers, hiding inside and taking over people's bodies. That's not to say they always look human, they can transform when threatened, quite a lot like Claymores, honestly. One thing that honestly put me off Claymore before I watched it was that all of the Claymores are women. No, I'm not sexist. I don't think anyway. I realised the reason this put me off is because of how anime generally handles women, rarely being strong characters and mostly used for fan service. But honestly, actually, is that just anime? Really, no. But let's not get into talks of sexism and the like. Rather, I only wanted to let you know not to be put off by the same thing I was. All the women in Claymore are great characters, and basically, as you should, you forget what gender they are. Not as in they're androgynous, just it's not a thing. There's no fan service at all either, which is one of the reasons I think this is the perfect anime to watch if you don't like anime. Hopefully when I said it was an anime, you did stay with me, because this is why. Honestly, besides being animated, there's no difference between Claymore and a Western TV show. At least not that I can think of just now. And a good Western TV show at that. Like I said, there's no fan service. The only Japanese word used is Yoma, I think. There's no chibis or anything, that kind of humour. It's kind of barely an anime. And if you do like anime, it's still great. Even without being an anime, as long as you like normal Western TV shows. The only major problem with it is that it didn't finish. It still gives a satisfying enough conclusion, but it only covers about a third of the story. So go watch it and then you can sign a petition for season 2. And then, if you liked it enough, read the manga. The books, if you're not familiar with the Japanesey words, to get the full story. It's the first and only manga I've finished so far. There's others I've tried, but this is the only one that I've really, really wanted to finish and absolutely loved. Honestly, it's an amazing show that I can't recommend enough. I can't see any reason you wouldn't like it if you like The Witcher. Go and watch it. Now, on to the side recommendations for things to watch after you've watched Claymore. These are things that I think go better with another game rather than Witcher, but they all still fall under the same genre. First up, to get a break from anime, is the only Western TV show in this video, the Shannara Chronicles. If you want to know why it's the only live-action TV show in this video, go watch my other video. I talk about that and why I think that is. So, what is it? It's the TV show is the Shannara Chronicles. The first season only just finished, but while cheesy-ish feeling at a couple times, it's a solid show worth a watch, at very least because of its budget. It looks more like a movie and has actual magic in it, which, as I said in my other video, is something I've really been looking for in a live-action show. It really scratched the itch I was looking for, and it's just pretty good. I'd recommend it. Next is Berserk, a bloody great anime. It's gory and dark and amazing. It's a bit old though, so the animation quality isn't the best. It also just feels a bit weird and off. It's off-putting for the first 10 episodes or so until you get used to it and get into it. But I think that feeling ends up being one of its greatest strengths. Actually, like another game that I can think of. Finally, as one I'm not sure if I should really be recommending in this video, Fairy Tail. I didn't realise for a while after I watched it that it really is fantasy. It just didn't seem like it. But when you think about it, there's magic, and the characters are wizards and all that stuff. So, I guess I find it hard to recommend because when I watched it, I didn't notice it was fantasy. But maybe if I were to watch it now, going in thinking that and knowing that it is fantasy and focusing, watching it for that reason, I guess, essentially, maybe I would notice it more and maybe it would count enough as fantasy. So I thought I'd mention it. You're better off knowing that it exists, even, rather than not. Thank you so much for watching. As I mentioned earlier, I've done another video about fantasy TV shows, which you might like. Or maybe just have a look through my videos and see if there's anything you fancy, and then maybe subscribe too. I also have a Twitter, so please follow me at TrekkieGaming. Also, please comment with other recommendations, because I've seen everything on this list, so I'm out of fantasy stuff to watch, basically. I need more. I'm praying there's something I haven't heard of that's amazing. So please comment and let me know, or just let me know if you've seen any of these and what you think. I'd love to have a chat about them. Would be really nice. Again, thank you so very much for watching. Until next time, cheerage!